2004, 2 litre T, convertible, 5-cylinder turbo. The wheels I've put on myself, they were £700. I've also got the standard 15-inch wheels as well with it. I think these are 17s. The number plate doesn't come with it. It is an 04 Edge. There's the mileage, 75,358. It was last serviced only 3,000 miles ago, so it does have a full service history. The stereo was fitted by me. It's an excellent piece of kit. It's better than I thought it was. All of these colours are fully changeable to whatever colour you want. When you first turn your car on, it automatically grabs the signal from your Bluetooth on your telephone, whether it's an iPhone or a Samsung S3. It grabs the signal every time. There, it also tells you what your battery power is and what your signal is on your telephone. You can make calls from there, you can receive calls from there. You can also play the music Bluetooth through your telephone. If you didn't want to do that, you can use an iPod, auxiliary jack just there. You can also use any kind of USB player because it's got a USB. The Bluetooth connection is plugged into a USB at the back. There's also a crystal clear CD player just there. And the sound in the car is beautiful. I think there's a subwoofer in here and loads of speakers, and it sounds really clear. This car also comes with climate control, not just air conditioning. It's two separate controllers for the left and right side of the cab, so you can just dial in whatever temperature you want and then just leave it. The aircon has been gassed up last year by myself, and it's really, really cold, very nice. And this particular model also comes with cruise control, which is very handy for all the speed cameras. You can just hit the cruise and then just worry about what's happening in front of you and not the speed. Some of these models came with a cup holder or a phone holder. This particular one comes with a sat nav. It's remote controlled sat nav. It's not fully up to date because I think it's one of the older models anyway, but I use this as like an emergency get home thing just in case there's a problem. It's nice to know you've got it. The menus on it are pretty easy to use. System off, enter. All the buttons on it that are supposed to work, work. The engine's beautiful. Absolutely silent. It drives gorgeously. The automatic gearbox has got no noises, clunks, jerks. Down changes and up changes are as smooth as anything on it. I've personally owned this car for 5 years now. The only reason I'm getting rid of this is because I need something like a Volkswagen Transporter van so that I can get my motorbike to track days. You can see there, it's got to be one of the best looking convertibles for this price anywhere. Just see if I can lift the camera up so you can see it from a higher angle. This is what made me choose this over the Saab or the BMW. The BMW didn't have the image that I wanted. I'm not that kind of driver. And the Saab I didn't think looked very nice. But I think this is absolutely beautiful when it's converted. It's got the full leather interior. The steering on it is power steering, of course, and it's even both sides, so the steering rack's in really good condition. As I mentioned, the gearbox is as sweet as a nut, and it's really nice to drive. Even with the roof up, it's really quiet. The rear seats are leather again, and they've got the headrest built in. And it's got two side airbags, I think, and the front airbag as well on the dash. So as I say, the reason I'm selling it is because I want a Volkswagen Transporter to be able to move my bike, my motorbike, to and from track days. And you can imagine it's not practical getting it in the car. But I have owned this for 5 years, so this is an advantage of buying it from me over a dealer, is the fact that, you know, this is my car. I know what's wrong with it. So speaking of what's wrong with it, I'm just going to show you the bad bits. There's a tiny little scuff just there, which can probably be touched in. When I took it for an MOT, it came back like that. I don't think it's actually creased, but it can possibly be pushed out or repaired. The wheels that I spent £700 on have just got a little bit of salt damage on them on the lacquer. Coming along to the side here, I think maybe a delivery boy or somebody caught the door with their pedal. And then I think the postman did this one. I think he might have caught that with his bag or something, just there. So, I mean, for the year of the car, for how old it is, 8-year-old car, I think it's in pretty decent condition. Tiny, tiny little scuff just there, look. But it does have reverse park sensors on it. So there you go. I'm just being as honest about the car as I can, but it's never let me down. It's been a fantastic piece of kit. And I will be sorry to see it go, but needs must. And at this price, it's a lot of car for the money.